Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So the one device that's done, the testing disciples, are the mothers of somebody that can learn. And what this term does is what the people speaking to each one of them in their native tongue. And you can see the list here. And just The word dialects, it's the Greek word for language, dialects. It's speech, it's language, it's conversation. It's peculiar to a people group. God's the word is supposed to be a word of self-government, that's a word. Thank you. is fucking something to do with. But the Lord has spirit together and the Lord lays down this opportunity for all of us in Christ. Peace. Verse 7. Verses 13 through 36. First of all, Peter says, you should tell me. this is a fact, and it's undisputed. Verse 23, and he was thinking about this teaching. And he would tell you that he's living in death, Christ is in control. He was predetermined, he was decided in the beginning of time, the creation of this world, its salvation, its rescue is already in place. This is not plan B. And then the resurrection, verse 24. The most miraculous event performed by God. The resurrection is mentioned no less than 11 times in the book of Acts. It's the truth. It's that which is undisputed. It's a faith in deep belief of numerous resources of non-believing Jews, Greeks, Gentiles. He acknowledged his defeat in the resurrection of Christ. He acknowledged it and to accept it into the victims. And to accept it means it's part of it. Cornerstone of his faith. And that's the lesson we learned. We want to read about the resurrection. Go to 1 Corinthians 15. Tell me that it's just too soon to know. And that we know. New Testament, and it's wonderful to come through the references and the scriptures describing the resurrection. These good things make the movie beautiful. First Corinthians 15. And then he goes in verses 25 and 35, three proofs of the Lord's resurrection and his ascension. The Lord is always with me. I will not be shaken. He is right beside me. My heart is glad. My tongue shouts in the face of my soul. This is Psalm 16. You will not leave my soul among the dead. I will not afraid of the dark in the earth. He will send me a letter of Christ and he will fill me with the joy of your presence. This is David's prophecy of the resurrection of Christ. This is what happened to David. David did not die and become resurrected. He died. So he died with God to Jesus. He died with God. Psalm 16. And then he goes to the end of the verse. He says, seeing the living Lord at his right hand. Seeing the Lord at his right hand is the idea of that. He's representing the coming continuum. That's the resurrection. Commences the sadness and praise, as I mentioned. But the promise of our resurrection is also. And the Son of God, the comforting witness lineage, Thank you. creation in Christ, the world in Christ, Christ, Messiah, the chosen one, the Messiah, the faith in Messiah, the practice testimony, the true Messiah, the Messiah, the chosen one. And with that, it's not only something, the one true God, and the Savior of the world. This is the world for sin. And the charge that comes from this in verse 36, this is Jesus, the one you crucified. You crucified. This team is Christian. And now, if you think about this, 3,000 of you believe in this, this day, this team is a very large crowd. This Jesus, whom you crucified.
Thank you.
How are you going to be up there and just be here at the same time? Everybody bring your chairs so you can come around and watch them. That's the recordings and those are the streaming and stuff. Facebook games. So we'll have this up and then I'll be back. But I'm curious for today, though, before we just walk away, study and learn this because there's history and technology in three particular ways in this as it launches the early church and continues to this day. Understanding that in the physical tradition, understanding the tradition and the resurrection will be one of the people that you need. You have questions, it's like answers. Study it. And then you will look at some of the ways in which you can find out what you will provide and open the door to the Holy Spirit to be in your life. Because that is the promise of that gift. Believe and receive the goodness and the Holy Spirit in your life. So you have an openness to that. And you can ask the same very question that God doesn't ask. What shall I do? What shall I do? Obedience to God does not stop with the door. It's about the obedience that we walk in the direction of Jesus. Thank you.